Bass Creek Outdoors presents Uncle Bucky's Outdoor Adventures.
You broke the jinx.
It's that big nine that I saw.
And he's got a freak rack.
We're gonna go out there, we're gonna kill us a turkey.
Successful Indiana youth hunt.
Good morning, everybody. Out in the Jeep, and I'm getting ready to head out. But before I do, I say a quick prayer. Thank you, Lord, for an awesome Thanksgiving, for family and friends, and for all you do, Lord. Watch over all the military out and about everywhere in the world. Lord, it's the holidays, and just bless them and their families. And watch over me as I drive today, and watch over the family as I'm gone, and keep them safe, and all of us hunters today. And we just give you all the glory and honor. Amen. Well, I'm heading down to the farm, so go see what we can see. Hopefully, that big body buck's still out there, and he'll come by me today, and we can have a little success. So I'll see you at the farm.
Well, we're down at the crib. I had to borrow a gun from Gary. I'll tell you that whole story later on. But I'm getting packed up, heading out, and I'm going to sit in the main blind that I normally sit in. Hadn't sat in it since last year, for over a year. So it's time to get out there, and I'll catch you back right at daybreak.
Well, it's getting about 10 o'clock, and I noticed out the side window a hawk down on the grassy path trying to kill something. It was out there for probably darn close to 10 minutes and was really neat to watch it try to kill whatever it was trying to kill. Well, I got out late for the evening hunt, right at 5 o'clock, so I've only got 45 minutes of hunting left, so here we go. Well, I've got about 15 minutes of shooting light left, the sun is setting, and pretty soon I notice three or four does ran by, and then really close behind them was a young buck. Well, they ran up the fence row, and I thought, well, that was neat to see them. So I got the camera rolling, and then right after them came another two or three doe going in the same direction. And then immediately following them just a few minutes was another doe and two or three fawn, and then after them another doe. Well, I pretty much thought that the gig was up. I called to them, and they kind of came my way, but they ended up going the same direction that the first group of deer went. So I thought the game was over, but it was just neat to see them. Well, it's getting about maybe 5-10 minutes of shooting light left, and I look out the back window, and I notice that three or four of the doe are out in the back field, walking directly behind the blind. So I open up my window that faces the back, open up the door, put my extra camera on the small tripod facing out, and just let the camera roll, and then I try to see if I can get a shot. As one of these deer start coming closer, they notice the four-wheeler and they take off. I knew I shouldn't have parked it there, but, you know, it is what it is. So pretty soon, another doe starts to come behind me, and I'm trying to coordinate the doe and the camera to where I've got the doe on camera. Every time it's on camera, I don't have a shot at it, and every time I've got a shot, it isn't on camera. So eventually, the doe worked around behind me, and I knew it was now or never, so I went ahead and took the shot.
Hammered this big. I mean, she is a biggin. I'm sorry I got the truck running in the background, but I just wanted to show you this doe. I'm gonna weigh her at home, but I'm gonna tell you guys, this might compete for my biggest doe I ever shot. She got some hams on her. I'll tell you what, use that 12 gauge of Gary's with the light fields, man, just put a hammer on her. I don't think it was maybe a 100 yard shot maybe, but wow, she's a biggin. So I'm going to get her field dressed and get her home, and we'll have a wrap-up at home and a weigh-in. Okay, my scale, it got broke. Told you she was a big one, boy. She ain't the biggest one I ever shot. 139 pounds. 139 pounds. Well, I'm back home. I did a prayer out in the field, and I talked a little bit. And I might add that in the video, but my Jeep was running so I could have the lights on, and it really had a lot of background noise. It didn't really sound the greatest, so I'm going to redo it. Thank you, Lord, for the life of this deer, for all you do, Lord. This is all you. Nothing to do with me. All I do is to go out there and pull the trigger or shoot the bow. But, Lord, you always amaze me. Just when, you know, you think you're down and out and you hit the bottom, you bring us back and you show us the joy and wonder and the splendor of your world that you give us. And we just thank you for it and give you all the glory and honor. Amen. Well, like I said, you know, earlier, our house got broke into and had some weapons stolen. And my buddy Gary that I shot the doe at a couple weeks ago in his woods, he's kind enough to let me borrow one of his single-shot H&R slug guns, and went out tonight and was able to harvest this great doe. The numbers, we hadn't been seeing the does down at the farm. I knew they were there. I saw the sign. I have 197 pictures of deer coming in an area in like a walkthrough in like 2 weeks. So I know there's deer there. Guys across the street been seeing a lot of does. Tonight, they came out of the woodwork. I had 9 mature does go through. I don't know how many fawns I had with them. There was a young buck that I've seen and I've passed up. And when I had the opportunity to take this, I wanted to see how Gary's gun shot before I hit the state park hunt up at Pokagon Monday and Tuesday. So I thought, you know what? Let's give her a whirl. Haven't shot a 12 gauge in a while. Really, it did a great job. It wasn't an overly long shot, but I think it was probably around 100 to 110 yards, but did a great job, though. She ran about 35, 40 yards and piled up, and the video footage isn't the greatest, but we got it on video, so that's all that counts. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. As always, take care, be safe, and you know, most of all, have fun.